Excel's fine can look like it's not working for a number of reasons. So just in order of what we think the likelihood is, let's say I've got the spreadsheet and I was working on this section here. Now I decide I want to look up lukewarm or Luke. I'm going to go Control F, find. I'm going to type Luke. And when I say find next, it tells me it can't find Luke, even though I can clearly see it there. The problem with this one is, the way find works is because we have cells highlighted, it only looks here. So if I rather click on one cell, when I say find next, you'll see it finds it. But the moment I highlight two or more, it then only looks in that area. So that's the most common reason for people not finding what is obviously there. If that is not the reason, one of the big issues is that find remembers what your last search was, and it can cause problems. So for example, now I'm going to just highlight this. You can see it looks okay. I'm going to go Control F. Again, I'm going to actually look for Luke. That's fine. When I say find next, notice it says it cannot find it, yet it's very obviously over there. The reason in this case is because if you actually look at that cell, you'll see it's actually a formula. And this find says look in formula. So it's actually not looking what it sees there, but rather what it sees there, and there is no Luke there. If I change that formulas to values, when I say find next, you'll see it goes to that one there. Let's just go the other way. So you'll see immediately it goes and finds that person. So you got to decide whether you want to look in values or formulas. And keep in mind, I'm going to just close this down. When I open it up again, it stays on values. So you need to be careful and make sure that that one is correct. A similar problem exists with dates. I'm just going to close this down, click on one cell. I'm going to look for January. So I'm going to go Control F and look for January. And when I say find next, it says it cannot find it. The reason it can't find it is even though we see 31 January 1970, if you look at that cell, it's actually stored in a different way. However, and that's because it was looking for the formula. So in theory, it wasn't looking at what it saw there, but rather what it sees there. If we change that formulas to values, and now for January, you say find next, you'll see now it finds it. So you'll be very careful about what this is. Is it values or formulas? Another problem relates to wildcard characters. So you'll see here, I can see I've got a few question marks, active question mark, terminated question mark. So I'm going to search for a question mark. When I say find next, can you see it's going to every single cell? So question mark and asterisk are wildcard characters. Excel does not see the question mark here. It assumes you're looking for any single character. If you're searching for question marks or an asterisk, you have to put the tilde in front of it, and then you'll see it goes to the correct cells. In this case, I'm going to do a find. I'm going to look for Luke, which I can clearly see there's a few of. And when I say find next, can you see it's saying it cannot find it, even though it's there and there? Just be careful, because find remembers what was previously done. Can you see it looks like someone looked for green? So they actually used this format option. And so what Excel is looking for is Luke that is formatted with a background or full of green. So what you must check is that this is what you want, or I'll say clear find format. When I now say find next, now it goes and finds it. Another option that can cause a problem, I want to look at Luke, say control find. I like to use uppercase, and when I say find next, you'll see it says it can't find it. That's because on one of my previous searches, I clicked match case. So it's looking for Luke, but it must be capital L-U-K-E, and none of those match that. So when you switch that off, it now finds it fine. In this case, I'm going to just highlight that section. I'm going to search for 3877. I know I don't need to worry about the one. So I'm going to go Control F, find. And we're going to go 3877. When I say find, it says it cannot find it. The reason is this has been ticked on, match entire cell contents. And so whatever you type here, it expects it to be the entire cell. So the fact we're missing that one means that it's not seeing it as the same. We tick that off. You'll see it finds it immediately. We're going to look for Luke again. We'll go find, look for Luke. You'll see it says it cannot find it. Now, if you look closely here, when it says look in, previously we've looked at formula and values, but now it's been told to look in notes. Now, if I search for Adrian in notes, you'll see it finds it. And if I hover, you can see why, because in there it says feedback from Adrian. The problem is when the notes are switched on and I search for Luke, there is no note with Luke in it. So I need to go back to either formulas, values, wherever I want to look. When I say find next, it then will go and find them for me.